Welcome to yet another wonderful Friday night session. Sorry for those of you who really wanted to tune in last week, but I'm happy that we are here now. All right, guys, we're going to start off. We spoke rivers last week. Show of hands, anybody who wants to start and show us what they've built. I know we've seen what Luigi has built. He shared it on the group. I don't know if anybody is able to share it here. I am currently not. But anybody else wanna start off and share a bit of what they've built?
There we go. Eventually.
Hey. Okay. Well, now you're screaming.
Okay.
At us.
Sorry. There we go. No. Okay. So if everyone can see that, that's basically. I've just made a little walkway with a broken, wood for going up to my little drive because mine's basically overgrown and stuff. So that's basically what I did.
That's very nice. Well done.
Can we zoom in a bit?
Yep.
Yes, I'd love to see it as well.
There you go. There we go. Thanks, Paul.
So that's basically that. That's the rendering of it. Okay.
Okay, I love the pieces of bridge lying down here.
Thanks, man.
Cool. Paul, can you share Luigi's with us?
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so he did a continuation of his little road with his berserkers. Quite like the direction of the river here. So he gives you an indication of which way the river is actually flowing. A salter. And I think he did a nice little extension of his. Well, it's not quite an extension. The road goes nowhere, but we'll have to see what he does with it afterwards. And that's Luigi's.
Can you stay on that one quickly for a second?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so. Luigi and I spoke a couple of days ago, and while he was building this, and he showed me a couple of pics, and he was after an element that Tony had. We spoke about it, the non-Lego blood splat, and I actually think he recreated it really nicely there with his dilapidated. That's like not decapitated, but when your bottom half be dilapidated is cut off. And also the way that he managed to take the straight river that he showed me in the first picture that he sent me, and he broke it up with some rock and some dark tan. If you look at the top where those other plants are, little pieces. So yeah, nice one. Fabi, you seem ready to show us yours.
Yeah, definitely. So I took away from the learnings that we did, what was it now, 3 weeks ago?
Yeah.
Feels like way longer. Funny how time flies weeks, when you're having fun. yeah, exactly. So I think what I did is, firstly, I worked on the road to make the road look a bit more, non-symmetric. And I think that came out very nicely. Then the second thing was using different colors as the base underneath of tiles, doing a little bit of rock work so that one actually gets a bit of texture popping up, and then continuing the theme as it runs through. You guys said that one must have natural barriers because rivers don't just sort of stop going in one direction. So a little bit of flat DBG there, and then continuing that into the ocean. Or into the river mouth, whatever you want to, how you want to spin the story. Again, with a little bit of some rock work. So yeah, I'm actually pretty pleased with it. I did maintain a spot for the croc, I think it's important to have Mother Nature still be part of it. So yeah, I'm very pleased with it.
I don't want to be that horse. I don't want to be that horse so close to that crocodile. You have to pay the toll fees, right? It's a camo croc, that one, eh? It's so camouflaged. I love it.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I think that's looking really good, Fabdi.
Cool. No, that's a guidance from the group, right? I mean, you guys said they were going to have to play with the different colors, and it was actually rather interesting rebuilding this probably 3 or 4 times. So I literally had Lego finger again.
Yeah, but it really looks good. You can see the difference.
I'm really pleased with it.
I think my favorite part of this is the water, the way that you've managed to make the water look alive, the different shades in the water from deep to shallow.
And also, you guys said that I needed to do the tracks kind of lining up to something. And I think that's there for the wheels cutting through the grooves, right? So I think there's a story to be told there, should anybody pick up on it. But yeah, very pleased with it.
Very nice. Very
looking
nice.
Looking forward to today's build, which is the green stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll get to that. All right. Cool stuff. Thanks a lot, Fabdi. Well done. Anybody want to comment so far on anything that we've seen? Paul, Hilton?
I think from my side, I mean, Fabdi? Is Fabdi still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
Exactly where you are with your picture now. Yes. You see where you created the tracks?
Yeah.
What you can do as well is like create the groove of them. Yeah, on the left. So when you go to the left, I see you got the tracks where you got your wheels going. But maybe on the left and right, like dark brown, where the tracks actually go into the water and go out of the water.
Okay. So actually do it a bit more groovy over here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that's very valid. Yeah.
Because that would look quite nice if you do like the track where the actually wheels go into.
Yeah, no, absolutely. No, I like that idea. I was battling a little with the water edge, I will confess, since I only had pure translucent little 1x1 round plates or pips or whatever. So it was hard to not overdo it and to still give it the effect of it being a river and waves washing up on things. Mm-hmm. But I think maybe cutting those tracks in there will make it just a little bit more real.
Yeah, because even that, very cool, if you look at that, that first where you got the gray 1x2s, and you can leave your stud, your clear stud as it is.
But yes.
If you just go one plate back, there we go.
Okay.
Just one plate back and then build it up. Or take the level down to the side.
Yeah, no, 100%. Cool. Well, that's a good comment. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks, Fabdi.
Cool. All right. Richard, do we have you back yet?
No, Richard is not back yet.
Not yet. All right. Anybody else? Joe? You got something to share? Is Joe not back? Seems like we're having a bad internet evening. Almarie, what do you have to share?
What do you have to share? Come on. Nothing.
All right.
No homework.
Okay. Well, that's the tension then. Okay. Is that Ken?
Yeah. Can I quickly share mine?
Go for it, Ken. Okay. Yeah. Just check the message, Hilton.
Yeah. Sorry, Richard just said he can't reconnect.
Hey, Ken.
Yeah. Can you guys see my?
Yes, we can.
Viewer?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, there we go.
So he's coming out from the so-called tunnel or the skull head. So that's a river. That's just the extension of the route that previously have done. Yeah, this is the river. So, yeah, the simple one.
Cool stuff, bud.
Very nice.
I was kind of I was expecting to see either the Monkeykin or a Monkeykin or ninja flying out of the the map opening there. but you can always put them in later.
Yeah, it's the skull hit or whatever monkey hit is coming out. Yeah,
here we go.
Yeah, I've just all played around. Yeah, so maybe. Yeah, cool. The plan is.
Paul?
Okay, cool.
You wanted to say something?
No, I just wanted him to zoom out a bit so we could see the rest of the
okay. all right.
Maybe, hold on, let me just see if I can...
Oh, there's the Monkey King.
Yeah.
He's in PDF format.
There's a... yeah. So it's the render.
Very nice.
That's the idea. So yeah.
Cool.
Okay, cool.
Very nice, bud. Well done.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
This evening's got me really excited so far. Well done, guys. All right. Anybody else? Have we got Richard back yet?
No, Richard is still not getting in enough. Joe is also struggling.
Okay, Rian, are you here with something or are you listening in just?
Yeah, I'm just listening. I'm too scared to show you what I've built. I've only managed two base plates sorted and ready to actually start building, but I haven't started building anything yet. So base plates are ready to go. You guys give me a second. I was just going to struggle through this whole... Stand by one.
Okay, you got to talk to make yourself go live.
Okay, this is as far as I got. That's the one. And here's the other one. So it's not much to show, but I'm starting to get there. So this is ready now to start building. But quite excited now. After I've spoken to you, really, I've got some nice ideas. So yeah, it's next meeting, there'll be something on here to show you guys.
Awesome. Awesome. Very ambitious 32 by 32s there. Love it.
I'm trying. We'll get there.
Perfect. Thanks, Leon.
Cool. All right. So who have we not done? Let's go through the list here. Peter, anything to share? We got Peter still?
I think it's his first evening, so I don't think he's got any.
Unfortunately,
he says nothing yet.
All right. Well, welcome anyway, Peter. We look forward to seeing at least 8 48 by 48 base plates full of vegetation next week. all right, cool. Okay, Hilton, Paul, you guys, you got anything you want to share with us?
I've got nothing.
Yeah, me neither.
Sorry.
Okay. So after our discussion last week on water, we had a quick moment there where we did not push tiles down. So I decided just to quickly put a couple of tiles together and this is not cool. Anyway, so is this, can you see that? Can you see is this background killing it?
There we go.
All I want you to see is the way that the light actually catches the tiles when they're not pressed down flat. When this background doesn't, sorry, this is my phone and Zoom. Anyway, so, and then the use of the little 1x1 rounds. I wanted to show the rivers that I currently have, but unfortunately, I could not detach them in time from the current build. So they're still in another room. All right.